The crowd is amped up, ready to get this season underway, as are we. Back with more in a minute. And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Opening day baseball on the show. It's the Los Angeles Angels going up against the Oakland Athletics. John Shambi on play-by-play. Chris Singleton providing the color. All right, partner, ready to go. Always a pleasure to get things started with you on opening day.
Well, happy new year, buddy. And anyone that's involved in baseball, even though it's not January 1st, this is the start of a new year. Every team has playoff hopes. I love this time of the year. I'm excited to get things going.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So just about set now. And the right-hander with the good curveball, Paul Blackburn.
Well, this guy has the ability to command the game. He's got to limit damage, make his pitches, and avoid that big inning. If he can work around that, he can give a quality start, hand this off to the bullpen later on, and put his team in a position to win a game.
So in now for the Angels, David Fletcher. The pitch. On the ground to third. Throw pulls him off the bag and he's safe.
Well, I hope that's not a sign of things to come in this one for either side. We want to see a good, clean game in this one. An error on the first play of the game kind of makes you wonder, but it's a great chance for this visiting lineup to strike first.
Gio Urshela to the plate. Payoff pitch. Ground ball right side, could be two. To Diaz for one. On to Brown, it's two. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Trout. Lots of pop at the plate. Outfield playing back almost on the warning track. Check swing, no appeal.
Gosh, Boog, I think he's trying to deke the pitcher. There's no way he's thinking he can hit that pitch.
The 2-1. And that one cutting but missing down low. And he deals. And there's ball four.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield, so I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed.
Now it's Hunter Renfroe. On the ground to short. They get the force. Third out, and that ends the frame. Angels strand a couple, and the A's will get their first opportunity in a scoreless ballgame. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back here in the East Bay, today's starting pitcher, Shohei Ohtani. What do we need to know here about the right-hander?
Well, this guy had a bunch of wins last year, and I'll tell you what, as a position player, when you've got a pitcher that's going to go out there, take the ball, and put you in a position to win, for whatever reasons, you're relaxed, you enjoy playing behind him, but you also are able to score for a guy like that, and that's who he was for his team last year, and I'm sure they're hoping they get more of the same this season.
Next one misses, and now 3-2. Kemp checks his swing. Appeal down to third. No, he held back. That's ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Now it's Chase Peterson. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Two walks in the first has to be some cause for concern. I mean, you're talking about a guy you want to pitch deep into the ball game. It's not going to help with the pitch count right there. They can't afford to hand out free bases at this rate.
And now it's Jesus Aguilar. Foul ball there. That one not close. 2-2.
Well, Boog, early on in this one, having a hard time getting settled in. He's not showing control to throw strikes, and let alone to throw it where he wants in the strike zone. This could be a tough one for him.
The next pitch misses, and a full count now. And here it comes. And they're all loaded up.
Now, that sets up a really big at-bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
Bases loaded, nobody out. Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Seth Brown. Next offering is fouled back. Bases juiced, no outs. Next pitch inside, full count now. Left-hand batter waits. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off-speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
Three, two on the way. Popped in the air, left field. Squeezes it, and there's one down. Ledmus Diaz now.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here. He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Swing and a miss. And that's strike two.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Got him looking. Huge strikeout there.
Well, that was such a great opportunity to grab the lead. You had the infield back. All you've got to do is just put the ball in play on the ground, and you drive across a run. It's a frustrating outcome for the hitter. Now, I'll still have a chance, but it's probably going to take a clutch hit with two outs.
Next to hit, Connor Capel. Next offering is fouled back. Two outs, bases are full. And a base hit up the middle. One run is in. Another scores. Two runs in on the play, and they lead by two.
Picks himself up a couple of ribbies. Wasn't able to elevate that one, but he sure hit it hard enough to get through the infield. There's not a whole lot of time for the defenders to react and try to make a play when it's ripped like that.
So two on with two away. Brent Rooker up next for the A's. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. And that one fouled off. Singy Shohei Ohtani has been as advertised. Rookie of the year in 18, MVP in 21. He has impacted the game in a major way. And then, of course, he was on the cover of MLB The Show in 2022.
Well, he's doing something that we've never seen done before, and just absolutely phenomenal that he can be that dominant on the mound and be one of the top hitters in the game. And just watching that, it's got to take your breath away a little bit if you're a manager or a teammate to see this actually happening before your eyes.
And the right-hander deals, and that'll load the bases.
So close to getting out of it right there, but this inning still has life.
Here's Ramon Laureano.
two outs. And that one off the outside edge.
That MVP I mentioned about Ohtani in 2021, he was actually a unanimous MVP and the first unanimous AL MVP since Mike Trout in 2014. Other guys that have done that, Ken Griffey Jr., Frank Thomas, Frank Robinson. In the air, right field. Brings it in for the third out. But two runs for him, and they jump ahead.
They move to the second here in Oakland. It's the A's two and the Angels nothing. Top of the second, and the batter now, Taylor Ward.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
The 1-1. And fouled off. And the righty deals.
Umpiring behind the plate for us today, Boog, is Mike Fillmore, and he is a good one. He'll reward pitches on the edges a little bit, but the main thing is he doesn't keep you guessing. Once he established that a pitch is a strike, it stays that way.
Swings and misses. Blew the express right by his bat for strike three. And now the first baseman, Jared Walsh. Swings through that one out in front that time. The 1-2. Bounce to the right. Kemp collects it. On to first. Walsh retired. Anthony Rendon making his way to the plate. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Up the middle. Throw on to Brown. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Angels held in check. And they're down 2-0. Welcome back. We head to the bottom of the second. Digging in for Oakland, Shea Langeliers.
All right, Singy, you know I'm a dork. Shohei Ohtani, go back to May 5th, 2022 at Fenway Park. He tossed a complete game through 99 pitches. Get this, 81 strikes. It was the most strikes thrown with less than 100 pitches in a game since they started tracking pitch counts.
That's just unreal.
Righty delivers. Swung on, belted. That's back. Grabs it right up against the wall. So the lineup flips over. Here's Tony Kemp. Look out! And it hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
You know, Boog, you always say how important it is to have a good feel for the game. I say after the game, you step into the box, I'll throw some fastballs at you.
No, actually, I think we're good, Chris.
Next pitch misses. It's 2-2. This is on the ground to Walsh. They get the tag on him, and that's the second out. Next up for the A's, Jesus Aguilar. And a 1-1. Bounce to the right side. Rendon, throw to first. And that is the inning. One left for Oakland, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Back in Oakland, Max Stassi comes up to hit. The pitch. In the air, out towards left center. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. And there's one away. Here's David Fletcher. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Diaz slings to first. Fletcher retired. Two outs, base is empty. Giorgella steps in. He's 0 for 1. Two down, nobody on. And that one lifted in the air, center field. Makes the catch, inning over. Angels go quietly there. They trail it here, 2-0. Set for the bottom of the third. So here's Brown at the plate. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does.
And I think that skill set really upgrades the position, because when you have that kind of speed, it makes the whole team that much better.
On the ground, right side, whips it to first on the run. Leadoff man retired here in the third. Aledmys Diaz now. One down, base is empty. Out towards left center. That gets down for a hit. So a man aboard now with one away. Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Connor Capel. He drove in two with a single his first time up. Gonna count 1-2. And the pitch. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Kicks and deals. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Left-hand hitter waits. And look out. That one gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one.
You know, Boog, there always seems to be that oh no moment for the pitcher when he's lost control of his pitch, and most of the time it's right when he lets it go. He knows that it's not headed where he intended it to go.
At the belt and fires. In the air on the infield.
Infield fly, batter's out.
So first and second with two outs. Digging in for Oakland, Ramon Laureano. 0 for 1 so far. Here comes a pitch.
Oh, that pitch is out.
Fly ball down the line. And it's caught. And that will end the inning. A's strand a couple. They're up 2-0. Back here at the ballpark, start of the fourth, here's Mike Trout. Next offering is downstairs. Kicks and fires. And a big swing and a miss.
Two balls, two strikes.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. The pitch. That's to third. Whips it to first. And one gone in the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
Good arm side run to that same side hitter right there. Very difficult to put that ball in the air or get through it. Just bores in on the hands.
Here's Shohei Ohtani. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. Here's a 1-1. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, with just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
Next pitch is downstairs. Swing and a tapper. Two quick outs here in the top of the fourth. Now it's Hunter Renfroe. The outfield playing him to pull with the center fielder positioned in that left center field gap. 2-1 now. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Smash that one through the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
So up next, Taylor Ward. His first at bat was a strikeout. Grips one to right and foul ball. That's towards center. And the inning is over. Angels leave one. They're still down. It's 2-0. And welcome back. Bottom four. Now at the plate, Shea Langeliers. Is a 1-1. They say it went.
One ball, two strikes.
Swings and misses, struck him out.
It's almost like he's telling the guys in the bullpen, stand down, I got this.
Next up for the A's, Tony Kemp. Next pitch is outside. Activity in the bullpen for the Angels. Griffin Canning getting ready to go. Right-hander kicks, deals. Fouls one off. 2-2. And a pitch. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
That's about as nasty of a splitter as you'll come across, especially in terms of movement. I mean, that thing tumbles out of his hand and just drops off the table at the last moment. If he keeps it down, it's just so tough to put wood on.
The 1-1. That one missing inside.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
And a pitch. That one fouled off, 2-2. The pitch. And down on strikes. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down, 1-2-3.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
Back here in the East Bay, ready now for the fifth inning. And here's the first baseman, Jared Walsh. And a 2-1 on the way. And a foul ball. Got him. And one gone. Now it's Anthony Rendon. Strike two.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Got him looking. Two away now. Two outs, base is empty. And next for L.A., Max Stassi. Hit it well, but flied out to the deepest part of the outfield his first time. And he deals. Swing and a foul straight back.
Now this offense has just been locked down. Almost five full innings of shutout baseball.
The pitch. Stassi started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first, no swing. And here it comes. Foul tip into the mitt, struck him out. Angels go down 1-2-3. They trail things here 2-0. Griffin Canning on a pitch out of the pen here.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
3-4-5 due up for the home team. Now it's the DH, Jesus Aguilar. And that one popped to short. Fletcher moves under it and puts the squeeze on that. And a quick out number one. Next is the speedy first baseman, Seth Brown. The outfield shifted pretty heavily towards right field. The wind of the pitch. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. And it's Aledmys Diaz. Ground ball up the middle. Fletcher handles the chance. The throw to first, and that is the inning. Nothing doing there for the A's, as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Now it's the Angels leadoff man, David Fletcher. On the ground, out to short. Gathers and throws to first. And that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground, nice ground out.
Here's Gio Urshela. And a pitch. High fly ball down the left field line. And that one gets down, fair ball. Around first and hustling for second. And he pulls in with a double for his first hit of the year. And now batting, Mike Trout. Got him. So he's gotten deep into this game, and at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue. Shohei Ohtani, the next to hit for the Angels. This guy has turned into a beast. Tying run at the plate. And that one just missed off the outside edge. Righty to the plate. And it's filled up.
Let's see if he's willing to use the whole field right here. Definitely pounding him away.
Left-hand batter waits. And he grounds one to the right side. He'll do it himself. And that is the third out of the inning. A double in the inning, but they leave him stranded. 6-7-8 due in the bottom of the sixth. It's the A's 2 and the Angels nothing. Bottom of the sixth inning. Now it's the right fielder, Connor Capel. Next offering is down low. Action in the pen down there. Jose Quijada, the lefty, looks to be getting himself ready. The 2-1. There's the strike. Popped up. And it falls. So a man on base to start the inning. Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Brent Rooker. Outfield deep here, trying to prevent anything over their heads. The pitch.
Ball three.
Fought off foul. Nobody out. Runner at first. The punch out there. One away.
Well, he clearly didn't recognize that curveball out of the hand and tried to check the swing, just went around too far, and you're hoping the umpire maybe missed it and they bail you out.
Next pitch is inside. 2-1. And that one clips the corner. Two now. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Well, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts. So they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
Right-handed reliever. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Righty delivers. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. To the right side. He takes it on his own. Gets him easily. Ends the inning. The A's strand one, but they're on top 2-0. Back in Oakland, Hunter Renfroe at the plate.
Man, he's been really good. About to hit that 100 pitch mark here in the seventh. Man, we'll see how far they're going to ride him, but it's been pretty good so far.
Next offering misses, and it's 2-1. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Trevor May getting loose out there. Mole, the power lefty, up as well. And the righty deals.
Ball three.
Now in this three ball count, down in the ball game, you've got to be very selective. Take your walk if they'll give it to you.
On the ground to third. Throw on to Brown. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
Oh, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Here's the left fielder, Taylor Ward. Liner, base hit.
Well, that may end up being an at-bat we go back to later on when this game is over. Hooked around that pitch on the outside, but he was still able to square it up pretty nicely, and that takes quick, strong wrist to pull that off. Now a huge at-bat in this game coming up.
And here comes Mark Kotze as he's ready to make a change and go to the bullpen. Paul Blackburn won't go any further. Two-run ball game as he heads for the dugout, and we'll be back with a new pitcher. On to pitch now for Oakland, Sam Mole.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with the lefty hitter coming up. I think it's a good move. I know I never liked when opposing teams did that to me.
And now, Jared Walsh. In the dirt. In there! He's safe!
You know, sometimes it takes a reliever a little time to get comfortable with the mound out there, especially when they come in trying to be nasty with every pitch they throw. Not exactly what they were looking for when they called him in, though. We'll see if he can settle down.
The next offering misses. 3-1.
As a hitter, you don't know what to expect here in the 3-2. If he'll throw a breaking ball 3-1, he'll do it again 3-2.
Up the middle, Diaz handles. In plenty of time to first, Walsh retired.
Deceptive slider right there, stayed in the tunnel a long time, got that hitter out front, rolled over it, put it on the ground.
Here's Anthony Rendon up to the plate.
And things could change quickly here with one swing.
Two outs. And one in scoring position. Next offering is downstairs. Good eye on that spot. And he walked him.
Pretty much the last thing you want from your bullpen arms are free passes, especially in spots like this. Make the team earn their way on.
Max Stassi, the next to hit for the Angels. Two outs.
Ball out there on the mound. He's got to go right after this hitter because you don't want to turn this lineup over. This is the guy that you've got to get that final out, get out of this inning.
Kicks and deals. Swing and he popped it up. Diaz moves under it. And that is that. Set for the last half of the seventh. Now it's the second baseman, Tony Kemp. Swing and a miss. And that is strike two. To the right side, Rendon collects. Over to first. One up, one down.
A well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
And the right-hander deals. And that's outside.
One strike.
Hard hit left side. And it goes just foul. And now it's 3-2.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Kicks and fires. And that's ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boog.
Here's Oakland's DH, Jesus Aguilar. Next pitch is downstairs.
Runner
on the goal. Pitch misses. Throw there. Safe.
You know, nights like this when it seems harder to score, I like the call to put him in motion and try to steal the base. Ball's not carrying, no home run so far, so trying to manufacture some offense like this may be the way to go.
One out and a runner at second. Line drive, base hit, right center field. Peterson rounds third, headed for the plate. He will score, and they're up by three.
Well, it was a great job of letting that runner steal second base, get in the scoring position, come through with the base knock, you add a run.
So, man aboard, and now the first baseman, Seth Brown, for the fourth time tonight. Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss as he was late. In the dirt, but kept close.
You hear people talk about letting the ball travel so often in terms of a hitting approach, and that's a great example why right there. If he's willing to let that curveball get a little deeper into the zone before he commits, he's way more likely to recognize that it's making a beeline for the dirt. On the other side, still a nice two-strike pitch, though.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner into scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
So digging in, Connor Capel.
It's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion, and he's in full speed. Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
That one is hammered right field. Renfroe moving back for it. Reaching for it and brings it in. But they pick up one run on the RBI single as the A's are on top. Back after this on the show. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth, Trevor May. Back to the top of the Angels lineup. Here's the shortstop at the plate, David Fletcher.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats, try to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth, that closer's coming in.
The pitch. And another ball. Bullpen activity starting up now. Zach Jackson, the closer, is getting loose. The 2-2. And a pop-up right side, foul territory. Grabs it on the run. And there's one down.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
And next for the Angels, Gio Urshela, 1-for-3. Fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Right-hander kicks, deals. Nope. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Oh, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make a call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
One down. So in now for the Angels, Mike Trout. At the belt and fires. Lace down the line, base hit right field. Urshela around second, on his way to third, and that's a double.
Oh, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high leverage spot right there. You see a ball come off the bat like that, you know it was pretty much a perfect swing. And for me, you know, I start wondering, and I'm looking on the computer, what was the exit velocity? This time, 106.
Now here is Shohei Ohtani, cruising on the mound right now, but a dangerous hitter here in this spot. A guy with some slug to him. Next offering is in for a strike. The pitch. That one off the mark. Two balls, two strikes. Looking for the K.
So far, just one of those days for this lineup. You get a couple of runners on, and you're looking at having a big inning, and that strikeout right there just pours water on the fire. You look for the next hitter to step up and try to do something, pick up his teammate and his club.
So a new pitcher on the mound for the A's, Domingo Acevedo.
All they need from him right here is one out, but that's easier said than done for sure. Lots of pressure with two runners in scoring position. He does have the one open base to work with if needed.
Hunter Renfroe, the next to hit. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. The tying run at the plate. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. One runs in. Now a second crosses the plate, and they trail by one.
Well, a huge two RBI swing of the bat right there. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
Substitution now at first base. Pinch running for the Angels, Andrew Velasquez. Two outs, runner on first. And next for L.A., Taylor Ward. And a pitch. Next offering misses down and away.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Acevedo over to first. Back standing. He's in there safely. In for a strike. Now it's 3-2.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And he deals. Got it! Good job at damage control right there. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. Home half of inning number 8 straight ahead. It's the A's 3 and the Angels 2. Now into the ball game on defense, Brett Phillips. He takes over and right. Welcome back. On to the bottom of the 8th. Now the left fielder, Brent Rooker. That one in for a strike, 2-2. Action in the Angels bullpen. Jose Quijada, the left-hander, up and throwing. Stays alive. The wind and the pitch. That one misses, and it's 3-2. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
And he reluctantly takes his walk.
Laureano comes up to hit. And a pitch. And that's outside. And there's a strike on the outside corner. Runner at first with no outs here. Next one misses, and the count is filled up. Here it comes. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch.
He's mixing his pitches really well late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
And that one handled. Feeds to second. Out there. Onto Walsh. That's two.
pretty lengthy at bat right there, and usually the hitter wins that battle after seeing so many pitches, but instead the exact opposite, or maybe even worse than that, grounds into a double play. Tough at bat to swallow.
Two down, nobody on. And a swing and a miss down on strikes. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Zach Jackson.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ballgame. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Well, one-run game, Jared Walsh getting ready to hit. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. Slapped foul. And a pitch. And now it's filled up.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And there's ball four.
Now a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
No outs, runner at first. Now it's going to be Anthony Rendon. The pitch puts a bunt down. The flip to the pitcher covering. That takes care of Rendon. And here's the catcher, Max Stassi.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. I mean, you get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it, but this is where they earn their keep.
This one in the dirt. Now the tag at third, and they got him.
Yeah, it's mistakes like that that you run yourself out of an inning. He's got to find a way to stay put or get there with ease. That was the potential tying run in this ballgame. Now they're going to have to figure out another way.
Looking to get the tying run on base. That one misses. And yeah, the closer in danger of walking the tying run. The pitch. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
They're not ready to go home quite yet.
And now the shortstop, David Fletcher. Here comes a pitch. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. And that'll do it. The A's take the series opener here at home.
Well, his first save of the season is in the books, and that was a nice job of him coming in the game and closing it out. He's off and running now.
A 3-2 final score in this one. Oakland hangs on to win it. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.